So good morning everyone. So welcome to my demo session 2 on performance testing training with JMeter. So we are going to, as discussed previously, we are going to start with JMeter in this batch. So yesterday I gave a quick demo on my training program, and today we are going to set up JMeter on our machine. Everyone to set up JMeter on your machine, right? So these are the software required for performance testing training. So I hope everyone have Zoom meeting installed on your machine, right? So please don't join from the browser, but install Zoom meeting on your machine. The next software that we need is Notepad++. Okay. So can you please install, if you don't have Notepad++, everyone please download and install Notepad++ right away. So search for, Google search for Notepad++ download. Go to the first link down notepad++.org. And click on the first link, download Notepad++ version 8.1.93. This is the latest version, as you can see here. And now, so select, go to download 64-bit. Yeah, here it is, download 64-bit. And click on this installer case. Can you please do this, guys, everyone, if you don't have Notepad++ previously? So I already have Notepad++ installed on my machine. So I'm not going to do this now, right? And once you do this, the next important software that you need to have is Java. Java 64-bit, please remember Java 64-bit, right? So first of all, please check if you have Java installed on your machine or not. And how to check that? How to confirm that if you have Java installed on your machine or not is, open a command prompt, type cmd in your Windows search box, and type here java space hyphen version base. Can everyone please try this command in your command prompt? So this command tells you if java is installed on your machine, it will show you the version that you are having. And observe here, I have 64-bit Java on my machine. So here you can see I have Java hotspot 64-bit version, right? So those who don't have Java installed on your machine, it will display a message saying that Java is not recognized as an internal or external command. So those who don't have, can you please share your screen? I stopped my screen. So if you don't have Java installed on your machine, if you don't see a message like this, Java version for this command, right? So Google search for download Java 64-bit, right? And go for this first link, java.com. And choose either of these, Windows offline 64-bit or Windows offline. All right. Here it's clearly mentioned as Windows offline 64-bit. So click on this link and download Java on your machine. And you first install Java on your machine. Once you install Java, open a new command prompt and try this version again. Try this command again and confirm that Java is installed. So once you have Java installed on your machine, so let's set up JMeter on our machine. So the latest version of JMeter is 5.4.3. That is the latest version. So how to download JMeter now, right? So Google search for Apache JMeter download and you land up on this site. Go to the first link, jmeter.apache.org. And here you can see the latest version of JMeter, right? And observe here, it's mentioned here clearly that it requires Java 8+. JMeter requires Java 8+ because JMeter is developed using Java programming language. So if you want to use JMeter on your machine, first you have to install Java, right? Java 8+ means Java 8 or higher version. You should have Java 8 or higher version if you want to use JMeter on your machine, right? And now once you install Java, right? So come to this website and download this, go to binaries, under binaries, download this zip file. Apache JMeter 5.4.3.zip. Once you download this, I have already downloaded just now. Let me show you that. Go to the downloads folder, and this is the latest version that I downloaded today, just now. So move it to some other folder. Please move it to some other folder. I'll move it to my G drive. So this is the latest version. So now extract this, right? Click extract all. Okay. And remove this, you know, version, Apache JMeter 5.4.3, right? So when it extracts anyways, it will create a folder again. It will create a folder with Apache JMeter 5.4.3 again. Now extraction is done, and you can see that we created a folder here, Apache JMeter 5.4.3, and we are ready with our JMeter, right? And observe here, there are some important folders that you need to understand. The first folder is bin for binaries, and you have docs, extras, lib for libraries. Lib stands for libraries. This is a shortcut for libraries, and licenses and printable documents and so on. Here, and go to bin folder, binaries folder. And this is how you can start JMeter, right? You see a file called jmeter.bat, right? Just double click it. So to launch JMeter on your machine, this is one way to start JMeter on your machine. This is one of the available ways. I'll show you what are the other ways. Let it launch, right? Now you can see, you'll see a command prompt like this, JMeter command prompt like this. And this is the JMeter GUI, as you can see here. Right, and here you can see the version 5.4.3, the version name here, and this is called as, by default you will see an element called test plan. Here you see an element called test plan by default. So we'll come back to this JMeter GUI later on. So just set up this tool on your machine. So I hope everyone is done without any issues, right? And so every time you want to start JMeter, you need not come to this folder, come to G drive tools, Apache JMeter and bin folder. You need not come to that. So what you do is, like, right click on this and keep a shortcut on the desktop by using this send to desktop create shortcut. Clear, guys? And this is the shortcut that was placed just now. Let me rename it as JMeter 543. Right? Right? Next time when you, if you want to start JMeter, what you can simply do is, you can double click on this desktop shortcut. So this is one way to launch JMeter. There are a couple of other ways to do that. We will discuss that later. So I'll take a pass here. So if you have any issues, or if you need any help in setting up JMeter, please let me know. So good thing with JMeter is, like, we don't need any admin rights on our machine. So you can set it up on your office laptop as well without any admin rights. Clear, right? Because we don't actually do any installation. We will set up JMeter on our machine, and we will start JMeter with the help of a batch file. So we don't need admin rights on our machine. Yeah. So before going to this, just give me a minute. Yes. So before going to JMeter, so let's understand what are the different performance testing tools. What are the important tools for performance testing, right? as you can see here, so these are the important performance testing tools. First one is Micro Focus Low Turner, which is a licensed version, right? And of course, it provides a trial version with limited capabilities. And the next tool, important tool for performance testing is JMeter. Well, Low Turner is very old tool, I can say. So it was developed first in 1999. So it's 21 plus years old tool. So the next important tool for performance testing is Apache JMeter. And it is the most popular open source tool for performance testing. Okay. And the next important tool is NeoLoad. And you have a couple of other tools like Webload, SilPerformer, IBM RPT, Gatling, Locust, Grinder, and all this. So currently, the major tools in the market are LoadRunner, JMeter, and NeoLoadX. Right? There are a couple of other tools as well. These are all Webload is again a licensed tool. SilPerformer is again a licensed tool. And IBM RPT is another performance testing tool. RPT stands for Rational Performance Tester, as you can see here. This tool was developed by IBM. And Gatling, Locust, Grinder, Load Ninja, there are few other tools for performance testing. Right? Now let's have some introduction about JMeter. So JMeter was designed by Stefanie Mazzocchi of Apache Software Foundation. So it's the most popular open source load testing tool with almost as many features as commercial tools. So no wonder that it is gaining market share year by year, right? And with JMeter, you can record test scripts, run large scale load tests, and view various performance metrics in easy to understand charts, right? I'll show you how to record a test script with JMeter if possible today. All right. And there is also an active community that makes it easy to find everything from plugins to answers to common questions. So being open source tool, it doesn't have any dedicated support team. However, it has some active community of users, right? Active community of users and developers. So that makes it easy to find everything from plugins. So I'll explain what is meant by a plugin in the coming up sessions. And the other open source tools in the market are Locust, as I explained just now. So Locust is an open source load testing tool that defines your user behaviors in Python and sends millions of simultaneous users to the application. So basically, what you need to remember that is Locust is a Python-based tool, right? Just like how JMeter is a Java-based tool, JMeter is developed using Java, right? So Locust is a Python-based tool. And if you want to learn Locust, like you need to be good in Python language, right? And it has beautiful user interface and you can easily see key performance metrics and all this. Our only drawback is that it requires knowledge of Python programming language. Grinder is another tool for performance testing. Again, this is a Java-based load testing framework that uses Jython. So Jython is nothing but a Java implementation of Python programming language. Yes, you need not remember all these points, but however, you have to remember that what are the other open source tools in the market for performance testing apart from JMeter, right? So this is all what you want to know, what you need to remember. So that's the reason I covered this. You need not remember each and everything. However, you have to remember that apart from JMeter, there are a couple of other open source tools in the market for performance testing called Locust, Grinder, Gatling, and all this, right? Now we are interested now in JMeter. So have an introduction to JMeter. So JMeter is the only open source tool that can be used for both performance testing as well as functional testing, right? That is the first and foremost important point that you need to remember. It is the only open source tool that can be used for both performance testing as well as functional testing. So it's completely free of cost as it is an open source tool and it has no license cost. It is a tool with zero license cost. And one more beauty of JMeter is like it is platform independent. Because JMeter is a 100% Java application, it works on any operating system. Clear case. As Java is platform independent and JMeter is a Java application, JMeter is developed using Java language, it works on any operating system. Clear case. And it has record and playback feature. So it provides record and playback with drag and drop features. Right. And distributed load testing, JMeter supports distributed load testing. This is another important feature of JMeter. And JMeter is customizable. When I say customizable, as JMeter is an open source, you can add your custom code to JMeter. You can customize the source code. Clear, guys? If you want to add some new feature of to JMeter, right? So you can download the source file and you can see the source file of JMeter here. Here you can see, right, under source, you have again a GIF file, right? You can download the GIF file and you can read the code and you can customize the code as well. Clear, guys? One second. All right. And the next important feature of JMeter is it supports multiple protocols. Now let's understand what is meant by a protocol. So anyone guess what is meant by a protocol here in software? Okay. So let me explain it. So protocol is nothing but communication language between your browser and server, or the set of rules for communication between your browser and server, right? And JMeter supports multiple protocols like HTTP, FTP, HTTP Hypertext Transfer Protocol, FTP stands for File Transfer Protocol, SOAP stands for Simple Object or Access Protocol, JDBC for Java Database Connectivity, JMS Java Message Server, and LDAP stands for Lightweight Directory Access Protocol. So this JMeter supports multiple protocols which are mentioned here, and it can also be used for testing database performance, right? And what are the different types of applications that can be tested with JMeter? What different type of applications we can test with JMeter, right? Websites which use HTTP and HTTPS can be tested using JMeter, and web services, we can test web services, popular web services are REST and SOAP, and we can test database servers performance. We can test FTP servers. We can test LDAP servers. We can test mail servers such as SMTP, POP3, IMAP, and shell scripts and TCP servers. So these are the different types of applications that we can test with JMeter. And please remember that JMeter supports multiple protocols, which are mentioned here, like FTP, HTTP, SOAP, JDBC, JMS, and LDAP. This is a brief introduction to JMeter, and let's understand what are the important JMeter pros and cons, what are the advantages and limitations of JMeter, right? With this, we will end the session for today. If possible, I'll show you how to record a script if you guys are interested to see that. So Apache JMeter is a leading open source tool built in Java for load and performance testing. So it's not a browser, although it simulates some of the browser's behavior. So we'll discuss that. How does it simulate the browser's behavior? However, JMeter does not execute JavaScript, Ajax, or CSS. So need some additional settings to behave like a real browser. Yes, I just want to give an introduction to JMeter. Then we will discuss what are these, what is JavaScript, what is Ajax, what is CSS, and all these. And we'll then start with JMeter scripting. Okay. So I just want to give an introduction to JMeter. So what are the advantages of JMeter? As we discussed just now, it is an open source tool. It's platform independent and easy to enhance the features by simply adding the jar files, right? And lightweight and easy to install and upgrade, and it's flexible. And however, there are some limitations for JMeter. So first and foremost important limitation is it supports limited protocols compared to the licensed tools like Loadrunner or Neoload, right? So it supports limited protocols compared to licensed tools like Loadrunner or Neoload. If you are already aware of Loadrunner, Loadrunner supports 30 plus protocols, around 33 protocols, 33 different protocols. Okay? So however, JMeter supports hardly 10 protocols. And it has high memory consumption. JMeter consumes high memory. And heap memory issue is common while running a distributed scenario on single machine. So we'll discuss what is this distributed testing and what is this heap memory issue. once we complete scripting, we will discuss this. And it is a good tool for testing web applications only, but not desktop applications. So maybe it has, you know, evolved a bit more than before. However, it is a good tool for testing web applications. And dependency on Beanshell and Perl for complex scripting. If you want to write some custom coding, we have to depend on Beanshell scripting, right? And JMeter's report feature having less features, which make analysis a bit difficult. And there is no dedicated support team because it is an open source tool. There is no support. There is no dedicated support team. If you have some issue, like you have to depend on Google, or else you have to depend on, like, your experience matters a lot here, right? Or you have to depend on Google search. That's it. And any other forums. But you don't have a dedicated support team, just like how Loadrunner and other licensed tools have, because this is an open source tool. And we cannot, one more limitation of JMeter is we can't run test executions in GUI mode. When I say GUI mode, GUI stands for graphical user interface. And this is what we call GUI mode. Right? This is the JMeter's GUI. Right? So, and this JMeter's GUI can be used for only developing the scripts and debugging the scripts. However, if you want to run the load test or if you want to run any type of performance testing, you have to run in non-GUI mode. You can't run test in the GUI mode. That is one important limitation with JMeter. So these are the features and these are the advantages and limitations of JMeter. And this is how JMeter does performance testing. I'll explain this in the coming up sessions.
Yeah, I have shared my screen. Hope you can see it now.
Yes.
So I had downloaded it and this is what the app is.
No, first extract the zip file.
Over here, from here?
Go to testing folder, desktop testing. Yes. Extract the zip file first. Right. While the extraction is in progress, like, can you check if you have Java installed on the machine? Can you
open a comment? Java is installed already.
Okay. Open a comment prompt from Windows search box. Perfect. Right. Yeah, you can close this. And can you please open that comment prompt once again? I want to explain. So while extraction is in progress, I just want to explain. Can you please reuse the same comment? Java space icon version. Okay, yeah. So let me explain this while the extraction is in progress. So Java version here, you can see Java version is 1.8.0_311, right? So this is basically Java 8. This number actually represents your Java version. And this is a minor version. The third 311 is the minor version. And this is the major version. So this means you have Java 8 on your machine, right? And which Java version that you have is, this is the Java version, Java exact actual Java version that you have. This is a Java hotspot, 64-bit Java. We call this as a hotspot Java hotspot 64-bit. Clear, guys?
Okay.
So if it is a 32-bit, you don't see this any bit mentioned here, actually. If you have 32-bit Java installed on your machine, it will not show that it is a 32-bit Java. Clear? Yeah, you can close that window now. Yeah, so once you extract JMeter, yeah, go to that folder, please. Let me clear this annotation.
Bin?
Yeah, you go to bin folder, yes. And hold on. So here you are not seeing the file extensions. You are seeing file extensions for only few files, right? Wait, please wait. You can see here. So you are seeing some file extensions and here, you know, However, you are not seeing this file extension. This file extension you are not seeing. Right? So go to View on the top from the menu bar. From your Windows menu bar, yes, go to View and check this one. Let me highlight it. Please check this file. Go to View one more time and select this checkbox, File Name Extensions. Yeah, now you can see the file name extension. See here.
Okay, these are.
See, previously you did not see this extension, Windows Batch File Extension. You simply saw that as JMeter. Now, this is one way to launch JMeter. Just double click on the JMeter.bat. That is a Windows Batch file. This is one way to launch JMeter. Can you please give me control of your machine, Vijay?
Okay,
so done. Now I got the control, so I can take control of your machine. And this is one advantage with Zoom meeting, right? With Google Meet and other tools, we can't take control of this machine, the participants' machines. However, with Zoom meeting, we can take control of your machine. Right? Now you can see your JMeter 5.4.3 is launched successfully. Here you can see the JMeter version over here on the top, right? And this is called, we call this as menu bar, file, edit, search, run, and this we call that as menu bar, right? This part, this is called as menu bar. And here you see the JMeter logo and JMeter version over here. You can see the JMeter version. Let me minimize this for a moment, right? And place a shortcut on the desktop so that you need not come to this folder every time.
Okay.
You want to launch JMeter every time, you need not come to this folder. Yeah. Go to desktop once, use Windows D. No, type Windows D on your keyboard. Windows D, D for desktop. Right. And find out where is that shortcut located. Just type JMeter. Type J.
Yeah, here it is.
Yes. Just rename that with your version. Right. And rename that. After JMeter, view 5.4.3. No, after JMeter, please view that after. You need not give 5. Vijay, please listen to me. So after JMeter, view 5.4.3 before bat. Before
dot. Okay. So shall I remove the bat also?
No, don't remove that bat.
Okay.
Before the dot, please give 5.4.3, not after dot.
Okay.
See, bat is a file name extension. You should not modify that.
Okay.
Yeah, JMeter 5.4.3.bat. Yes, good enough.
Shortcut also, can I remove?
No, you can remove that shortcut. Yes, perfect. Now, launch JMeter, try to launch JMeter from here.
I think just double click on
it. Yes. You can start another instance actually.
Okay.
While it is running also, you can start another instance of JMeter.
Okay.
Now you will remember the version that you are using. If you keep the JMeter version.
By just looking at the file name, we can understand the version. Yeah.
Correct. Yes. I'm stopping your screen sharing. Thanks.
Okay. So shall I continue sharing my screen?
I stopped your screen share. I'm sharing my screen.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Anyone else face, is anyone else facing any other issue, or you are good with setting up JMeter on your machine? So I'll share the required sample application space. Okay. So whatever applications required for, you know, for the scripting purpose, I'll share this. I'll share this WebTools application and Konakat application and AOS, you know, VOS also. AOS is available as an online application as well. So for the moment, we will use that. However, I will share this, you know, like MySQL and Tomcat installation. We will do that in some other session. All right. So please share your email ID separately on WhatsApp, so that I can share the required software to you. I'll close the session for today. So, and we'll continue tomorrow. Any queries before we close the session? So thanks for watching. For the recording purpose, please like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Have a nice day. Thank you.